All right, this should be the start of the part two wet sanding video. I just changed to 1500, which is the most finest paper I have. I had two full coats of black this time instead of sanding between each one. I gained a lot of knowledge during that first part one video from the comments, especially from one guy, I can't remember his name. But he said, just go ahead and pile on the coats and only wet sand once when you're done to finish it. And one thing really stood out to me that he told me that stuck in my head. He said you want it flat and not glossy after the wet sand before you continue. And I couldn't understand how that can possibly turn out glossy like that when I've sanded away, very fine sanded, most of the gloss away. And he taught me a trick that really works. He said, go ahead and put some water on it, and it'll look super glossy as long as there's water on it. And when it dries, it's flat again. And that's exactly what happened. And he said it's the same effect with the clear coat. It may not look glossy now, but when you put the clear coat on it, it's sort of like water in a sense, and it's going to make it look glossy, even though it's not. So as hard as it is to believe that this is going to turn out glossy, as dull as it looks, I've seen it. When I dunk this in water, it's bright, shiny black. So I'm going to go ahead and continue with this pattern, and I'm going to do some clear coats probably tomorrow. It's still kind of wet, and I don't want any water drops or anything screwing up the clear coat. So I'm going to continue with this tomorrow. Here's another one. You can see I got most of the black gloss off. It's a nice, smooth finish. And the last two in one shot. So that's after my 1500 wet sand. It took all the gloss off it, and I'm just going to see how this turns out. Same thing with the clear coat I'm going to use tomorrow. I'm going to put two or three coats of clear coat. I'm not going to wet sand between each one. I'm just going to layer them up. You can go real light dustings on top of each other, on top of each other, making sure it dries. Then you finally do your wet sand at the end. And the last step is to use your rubbing compound and try and bring it out. So that's what I'm going to be doing tomorrow. Now I'm putting my first dusting of clear. Just a dusting to start with. And I'll do some more when that dries. Alright, I'm about to put on my third and last coat of clear. This is amazing, really. You remember how dull and flat and totally lame it looked before I put the clear on? Then those commenters were right. It just magically changed that flat, dull black appearance to shiny just with the clear itself. So the black did not have to be shiny under there. That's pretty cool. So I'm gonna just do one more coat. Or it already has a nice shine on it. Then I'm going to really let it cure for many hours, maybe till tomorrow, before I sand after all this work. I got to make sure it's cured completely. Away one at a time. That's about it for now. So I'm just about to start sanding my three coats of clear. They came out real nice. Look at that. It's almost the same as the factory grill I was talking about. I've never had it come out this nice. So the key is really just a flat black underneath the clear is what somehow makes it work. That's some really nice black right there. Can't wait to sand it a little smoother. Then do some buffing later. I do have some spottage right here, you can see. It's not perfect, but I'm hoping the sand will take care of that. You can see here, I've just done the first step of 3M cutting rubbing compound. And the old ones, see, they have that flat kind of scrape to them. And this compounded one got rid of all those lines and grayness out of it. And now it's kind of consistent. I did two compounds. I don't know if it's supposed to be any shinier. It looks pretty good. I'm probably going to try some polish next on this first one, which is the only one that I've done so far. So I just, first I did the 3M, Then I did the Swirl X, and then I did the Meguiar's. This is one finished strip. Although it isn't factory flawless, it's the best looking gloss I've ever done on these strips compared to these dull ones that haven't been done yet. See, they're all scratched up. This is a pretty close to factory paint. I've never done paint this good. So this was an awesome experience. Oh, I gotta do a little more at the top. There's a little bit of gray. But overall, was it worth it? Well, it was days of work. But in the end, if I can put it on without screwing it up, then yeah, it was worth it. This is the closest I'm ever gonna get to factory color using spray paint at home.